I will demonstrate a cataract operated with the six technique. Six stands for small incision cataract surgery and is a modified ECCE technique. The six technique is widely employed in Asia and Africa. This female patient is 94 years old. The nucleus is rock hard and the visual acuity is light perception. I started with two paracenteses and continue now with a limbal peritomy at 12 o'clock. The main difference between a 6 technique and an ECCE technique is the main incision. In an ECCE technique, one performs a limbal incision, and in a 6-6 technique, one performs a wide scleral incision. The anterior capsule is stained with Vision Blue. Then the rexus is performed. Important for the rexus is that you perform a large rexus. Why? In order to luxate the nucleus out of the lens capsule. If the rexus is too small, you will fail to luxate the nucleus out of the lens capsule. Therefore, perform a large rexus. The next step is the scleral incision. I'm using a 15 degrees knife and making a 8 mm broad frown incision. It's approximately 1 mm deep. The next step is the dissection of the scleral flap with a bevel up crescent knife. For details of the knives, see the book. You should not be too deep and not be too high with the knife. If you see the knife through the scleral tissue, you're just at the right height. Now you see the knife through the scleral tissue, so you're at the correct height. Remember that the frown incision is V-shaped. This scleral flap is the most important part of the six technique. If you open the anterior chamber, don't come too close to the limbus, otherwise you will have an iris prolapse. Not too close to the limbus, open it further inside. The next step is hydrodissection. If the rexus is big enough, the lens will luxate now into the anterior chamber. The nucleus can be rotated, but the lens does not luxate into the interior chamber. Therefore, you have to luxate it mechanically, left with the manipulator, push-pull, and the right with the viscoelastic cannula. Luxate the nucleus up and inject viscoelastica inside the lens capsule. This is important in order to prevent to damage the posterior capsule. Inject viscoelastica below the nucleus, and now you can luxate the nucleus into the interior chamber. And you do not risk to damage the posterior capsule. I'm using again on the right side a push-pull instrument and rotate the nucleus into the interior chamber. Again, injection of viscoelastic between the nucleus and the endothelium and between the nucleus and the posterior capsule in order to protect the endothelium and in order to protect the posterior capsule. The following step is the complete opening of the Frauen incision with the 2.4 mm blade. Remember, perform a V incision, a V-shaped Frauen incision. Next, you have to bend a fishhook, take a 27 gauge cannula and bend the fishhook as shown in the video. This technique is also shown by YouTube. Insert now the fishhook. And pull out the nucleus. Nucleus got stuck. Don't continue, but widen the Frauen incision with the 2.4 mm blade. Then start a new attempt with the fishhook, insert the fishhook, and extract the nucleus with the fishhook. A very brown nucleus. Then continue with irrigation and aspiration. Just as in normal phaco emulsification. Inflate the capsular bag with viscoelastics and insert a PMMA or a three-piece IOL. You don't need to fold the IOL. It fits nicely through the Frauen incision. Insert the IOL into the capsular bag. Then close the Frauen incision with a Vehicle 80 cross stitch. This step is maybe not necessary. The frown incision is actually watertight. I prefer to do the step in order to sleep better during the night. But I would definitely not perform more than one cross suture here. And just in order to have a form stability of this broad incision. Don't pull the suture tight, you don't want an astigmatism. So only light in order to have a form stable tunnel incision. The next step is the closure of the conjunctiva with Vicryl 80. The final steps are the removal of viscoelastics with the IA handpiece and the hydration of the paracentesis. Thank you very much for your attention.